go, hell yeah. And here's Benkei, talking about ghetto rays, and here's a mysterious dude called that Guy. Yeah, here's a dude whose name doesn't matter. They're like, wait, where's Viral? So apparently, Viral is, like, they live in an underground village, and Viral has been protecting them. And they're on the surface now, and they're headed to Kamina City to get some monsters, and here's a lady called Kay. She's fucking wild. Yeah, and here she says that Kamina City is named after Kamina, the leader of the Great Gurren Gang. And then she calls Benkei, Dad, you knew Kamina, what was he like with his life? Like, yeah, he's pretty good, I guess. And, yeah, and, Benkei's like, where did you hear that name? She's like, from Viral, and he's like, oh, that guy always fucking, oh. She's like, so, Dad, tell me, why have a bunch of humans gone back to living underground? And then he gets all mad and intense. He's like, I'll tell you when we get there. He's like, why tell me why we're living underground? He's like, I'll tell you when we get there. When we get to Kamina City, I'll tell you, alright? And then in turn, he's like, yeah, but I'm also going to ask Hayato what the fuck he's thinking. She's like, damn, Dad, what's up? Let's go to Kamina City. So here's Hayato on the bridge, talking to the other top people. Telling us what's been going on for the last 10 years. It's pointless to try and talk, like, decide which time stream is correct or whatever. And that reminds Roger and the other Zooth people of the multidimensional world they come from, where there were some people from the future and the part, oh, it was weird. And Hayato acknowledges that he was fighting against Shindragon at the time of the quake. And Hayato thinks that Shindragon caused the quake that caused, like, made the Dark Continent be cut off again. And Professor Shikishima over here is talking with the various pilots. And he shares this theory. He believes that Shindragon caused the quake to avoid getting hit by the graviton missiles, with the big deuterium goddamn missile that we saw in the prologue, and then there was a huge explosion and Ryoma yelled. And this dude, so Shodro is like, Professor Shikishima, are you in relation to Professor Shikishima who took me in as a child? He's like, hell yeah, I'm his dad. He's like, wait, really? He's like, nah, I'm just kidding, you idiot. No relation at all. Yeah, he's like, ah, ha, ha. Yeah, so he's like, ha ha ha, for an Interpol agent, you sure are gullible, kid. And he's like, wow, what's up with this dude? He's a lunatic. But anyway, nobody knows, yes, so Akagi asks what happened to Shindragon, and he's like, no idea. Nobody knows what happened to Shindragon, and all the pilots and mechs that were there that day were thrown all over the Dark Continent in the aftermath of the quake. And apart from the dimensional isolation and the elevated ghetto ray count, the continent hasn't done so bad, and Shikajima's been roaming around trying to figure out why. It's taken a good 10 years, and in that time, Simon and the other Great Gurren Gang members have formed a government that's kept everybody safe. So they ask, what are the other ghetto boys? What are Ryoma, Benkei, and Musashi? Yeah, that's what Koji asks, and they're like, And Shikajima says that Musashi died fighting Shindragon. He's just fucking dead. And Ryoma and Shingera are both missing after the big explosion. And Benkei and Genki have both been living in the Badlands. Probably because they're opposed to the way the government's been doing things. Viral was the leader of the resistance, but now that he's been captured, it's probably all over. And we're like, wow, this is all fucked. We don't like any of this. Everyone's frowning. He's like, what's up? And we're like, man, we got a lot of questions. Like, we fought Lord Genome, and he gave us more questions, and... oh, man. Jeez. Like, it seemed like it was just a fight then between human and beast men, and now it's something else. And Benkei and friends are clearly living in harmony with the beasts, because Viral's friggin' looking after him, so that means we're back to ideological clash, and Shikajima's like, I can't explain it. But, is that just because, like, is he just saying that because he's not willing to discuss them, rather than he's like, oh no, I can't really summarize it. But Gimmy says, no, it's the rules, there are the rules. Gotta follow the rules. Roshu made the rule, you gotta follow the rules. And then, Shikajima says that Gimmy is a Roshu apologist. It's like, oh, Gimmy and Nari, they were called Roshu, and he was the little boy. It's like, yeah, he's not so little now. He helped design the grapples, though. And, but while the rest of us are still dubious about this, Shikajima was like, alright, just wait till we get to Kamina City, and then you can talk to Simon. But, alarm, what the hell could that be? And then, Tower Crew and the Grapple team and all members of Zexis invade. We've got a 99.2% match on Invaders. What the heck? Invaders? And apparently they haven't been, they haven't been heard of since the Dark Continent became isolated. Which raises interesting questions about their relationship to the continent and the people on it. But Shikajima is just like, the Invader's presence heralds the approaching Armageddon. And then this is, Sortie, New Warriors. And now we launch nerds. I don't want to launch anybody else again. Here we go. Get a razor shorter than a number on this, and it's like, alright, give me Dari, you might not remember Invaders. It's like, hey Crow, we haven't seen you for a while, don't worry, the Grapple can handle anything. Alright, but please, just call me Crow, don't call me Mr. Crow, don't call me Crow-san. Oh jeez, here come Invaders. And yep, it's the Invaders. But we were ready to beat them up, and Hayato and Shikajima go, okay, the Invaders showing up means there must be a marker nearby. Marker nearby. Could it still be alive? Then we've got to finish the stage in 4 turns. Nothing too rough. Give him the old breast fire. Got him. Wouldn't have got him without the crit, I don't think. So, that's nice. Yeah, I definitely want to accelerate into that big old mess back here.
Scrounder!
Vader's gonna have to try harder than that. Let's smash this damn monster. Let's put her there. Okay, not there. She can blammo that dude and then give the other dude the Kamehameha. And then grappe combo. Zambo's been fighting monsters for years. Let's go, buddy. Too many eyeballs. Well, they went wrong. Didn't crit, no bop. No problem, really, with them. No problem. High five. You should start a gang, sleepy gang. You snap all the time. What's wrong? The time is now. Yeah, right. Fight Esther, see if I care. She did the cat fairy noise. I You think she really is a cat? No! She gave up on that dream because it's not real and she made it up. We did it! Keep it up, Vanessa. Here comes the Super Robot Army. She gave up on it because she achieved. That's not how giving up on things work! You don't give up on something you did, you just achieve it. This tower can fight you. Because she was big. Why? Face. Scuba dude. Fuck Scuba dude. No, you don't give up on trying. No. No, that's not how it works. Jack just getting what? Yeah, he deploys the Super Robot Army. Uh oh. On the air, if Federation Force is incoming, is it ALOS? What the heck's that dude? And here's Schwartz! In the Stiller. So, these guys have shown up. His is the latest prototype Super Robot. And he's here to beat up some invaders. It's like, wow, look at that dude. Yeah, so Psyche knows what it is. It's like Coco Boga, is it? Super? It's like, yeah, it's the latest prototype Super Robot. Nice, it's coming to help us. I mean, I guess Roger's like, what the hell are they doing here? And with such impeccable timing. So let's go fight some invaders. Ah, shit, look at that. One of them's become a potato. And then he says it's the whatever 8000D robot is fused with that invader. What the heck? That's no good. And Shikajima's like, wow, brilliant. I fucking love it. I can't believe it. They fused with the very machines bought to defeat them. They've evolved since last time. All the regular Fedi dudes die because they're all trash. But Schwartz is like, impossible. Just wiped them out. It's like, incredible. Power invaders. Then Ashura shows up and is like, exactly as foreseen. We knew they would evolve. It's a mad woman. I don't know what's going on. It's like, yeah, that's banished. She's nothing but trouble. The Dr. Hell sent me, and Haito's like, you're gonna tell me everything you know, alright, about the invaders. Like, you gonna make me? He's like, yeah, actually, I am. But here's K Guy and Benkei hanging out, yelling about friggin'. So Benkei tells everybody these aren't normal invaders. And a weird potato one comes over shooting at him, and like, duh! Dad! It's like, jeez, they're gonna die! And Asher is causing trouble and being a real jerk. When suddenly, Shingeta. And here's Go. What? Get a Robo. It's Shingeta. Cockpit's open. Go looks intense. Haven't seen you since Shin Dragon. Go. Get in. You want us to get in? It's like, well, I mean, we better get in. Getter Robos need three people to pilot them, so let's get in. Alright, Getter, let's go. Shingeta. Shingeta's around to that man. But Hayato and Shikajima are amazed to see that it looks just like it did 10 years ago. And then Shoshi's like, that friggin' robot! The anti-invader thing! K get her over. And then Asher here is like, ugh, the apostle of destruction must be eliminated. And now we gotta do a big fight. And go because that's that dude, he just loves to hoot and holler. And Schwartz is American, and he pilots the Silver Super Robot turns into a plane with a little dude's head stick out the front. He looks stupid, and he's an idiot. But he'll try his best. Gonna give that dude the photon beam. That dude the regular bop-em. Oh good, now they're gonna try and steal bops from me. Fuckers. Yeah, go on. Let's grab the cover. Leave that statue alone, I wanna kill it. You fucker. Alright, that's it. It's fucking gonna die now. I'm gonna kill every last one of these invaders. What the heck? Now we're in the friggin' getter? What the heck? That's no answer. But here it is, it's fused with a robot, and it's just a big potato, and it's awful, look at it. Beta, they've evolved. Testicles look like drain them. No. No. They look way worse than that. Look, that is this fucking thing. It's an egg with a fella in it. Bunker! Let's go into the bunker. Yeah, he's got no juice, so he needs to do this. Because the invaders hit him and drained him of all his juice, unfortunately. So now he can only rocket punch. Well, with the crit, he's doing 2 more damage than he needs to kill him, so that ain't bad. Moon him. You got 10 minutes or I beat the shit out of you. Shithead, eat this. Oh. If you're not killing them. Yeah, our count's gonna dunk on all these shitty statues. He's even killing the big planes too. Right then. Yeah, here's the Schwarzenegger. Look at it, just a little fella. Gatling cannon knife missile. Super robot bullshit. It's got a mission. These things ain't gonna stop it. Japan Super Robot's got nothing on this. The other Jokers aren't even in it? That seems a little ridiculous. Invader, mate, friggin' invaders! Never leaving us alone for a second. They've evolved. He never explains himself and it annoys the shit out of Kay. How do three people pilot the same car? It can transform! Get a 1, 2, and 3! Three. 3's worthless, 3's always terrible. But 2 is at least really fast. Three's the one that's for underwater, but you never go underwater, so it's pointless. Gone to all your fish yet? No, that's the thing, because this one can fly. So you don't even have to go in the water. So it's completely pointless. Completely worthless. Thanks, Luke Shadow. Give me that big spigot. What if the enemy's underwater? Then it depends on the weapons rating, but I believe that Shingera does alright attacking things in the sea. Friggin' invaders, never thought. don't worry, girl, it's fine. It's like, don't worry, these big, like, it's a big machine compartment, don't worry, we'll get data and sell it, it'll be good. So let's go, evolved shithead. Like, if you have to go deep underwater, like, the only time Getter 3 is even ever used in the TV show is at the bottom of a lake, like straight up at the bottom of a lake, and there's weird shark dudes swimming about. And he just sits there, shoots his missiles, spins its arms about a bit, and that's it. It has straight up like 2 minutes across a full TV series as 2 minutes of action. This is terrible. Getter 2 runs really fast. Getter 1's the best one. Has all the best moves, and Getter 3, it's slow and fat. You want to sell another this one is happening? Maybe, maybe. And I think Crow's gonna murder that with his follow up. So that's good. Awful. There was one toy I had that was a little scuba dude, but he had a little thing you could open in his stomach and put baking soda in, and then you put him in the bath and he'd sink, and then he'd fill with water and the baking soda would bubble, and then he'd float again, and then he'd sink, and then he'd float again. He'd just keep going up and down. It was good as hell. I'm Zero. I will sort this world out. Boing. Can't even kill a mecha beast, dude. What's up with that? These jokers. But they're currently like the lowest level dude on the field. That should solve that. Let's go. free diving, just hold your breath and eventually get to get because that's fucked up. Oh, and then you have to put them all back to the nuts and bolts together again, pair them up. That's fucked up. The thing we had to do at school was we just had to pick up a brick. You had to pick up a brick from the bottom and bring it back up. While fully clothed. That's fucked up. That's no good. I don't agree to that. They're not even boss health boys anymore, who cares? Yeah, like the trick with free diving is like staying calm and making sure that your body doesn't go, wow, we haven't breathed in a while. That's no good. Big Odon.
よくやったね。操縦してるのは私なんだが、できればこのような手段に訴えたくなかったが、仕方ない。せっかくのパーティーだ。大盤振る舞いと行こう。
For his stupid gun.
ソーボーバンの1枚や2枚くれてやる。スーパーロボットは日本だけのものじゃねえんだ。
do the knife.
Easy na mission da na.
The thing is, knocking your face as much as you can't, like, damn. Like, that just takes a lot of concentration just to do that. Oh, what spell did he fucking do? Oh, invincible, great, brilliant. Useful. To fucking nobody. Bring him. I hate swimming.
いるつもりはないのだがな。
Retreat! Another Mecha Beast down, pure trash. And then Hayato, friggin' Dr. Hell, what's he doing here? Everything all wiped up. So here's Go being mysterious, and Kay's annoyed at him because he's an enigma. And Schwartz doesn't really have much of a choice but to hang out with us now because everybody in his unit died. Yeah, he's got his mission to check the Dark Continent, so he'll hang out with us. He's not thrilled with hanging out with Zexis, who is supposedly anti-Federation, but Zero just says, judge with your own eyes what results we produce. If you think we're anti-federation, then so be it, but check it out. And Swartz is like, all right, Mr. Zero. And for having free run of the ship, he tells us that A-Laws are on the move. And he hates them as much as he hates us. So, I mean, that makes him the perfect member, I guess. And then Benkei walks in, he's like, Hayato. Benkei. And he says, sir, explain to me what the government's up to. And Hayato asks if Benkei left Kamina City for Genki's sake. And Benkei just says that Genki died in an accident. I see. And then Kei comes in and he's like, yo, dad, what are you doing? He's like, get out of here, I'm friggin' talking to the friggin' Hayato. And he's like, oh, this is your daughter? And then internally he's like, this must be why Go sprung into action. He still doesn't explain about the government, what they're doing, and he just says that suffice to say what they're doing is necessary, and in the days to come, the weak will be unfit to live. And Benkei's like, what the fuck are you talking about? Kisama! But it turns out he's been wounded and he's bleeding all over the show now. And Hayato's just like, wow. Must be, it's like, this dude, this tough dude, was able to pilot the Getter in this condition. And then, like, Hayato, and then he tells Benkei to rest in bed for now and vent his grievances to him when they get to Kamina City. Go, meanwhile, is just sat here like Kiriko in perfect silence ever since he got in here. And, yeah, and Wada's like, wow, he's even worse than Kiriko! But Guy and the other dude, this dude, haven't seen him, never even heard of him before. But all they know is that Benkei met him once before and his name. And then Kei comes in, it's like, my dad's fucking in a hospital because he got hurt when we got out the hole. He's like, he's alright. He's like, is he the Getter, dude? He's like, yeah, he's fine. Don't worry about it. And then Go comes over. He's like, what's your freaking problem? Go, what are you doing? And he just says, I will protect you with the Getter. He's like, well, what's up with that, dude? He's like, and then Sayaka's like, is this his idea of being romantic? He's like, alright, if you're going to protect me with the thing, sure. So, why are you protecting me? And he says, because you are being protected by me, here, now. It's like, that doesn't make... Why are you protecting me? Because you're protecting... That doesn't make any sense. Shut up. But then he says he's protecting her from the return of the invaders. It's like, but the Getter needs three pilots. And then the girl says, you're in. He's like, what? It's like, you need three and... I mean, Dad can't because he's injured and you're the mechanic guy, like you were a mechanic. And there's nothing better to do. And I mean, you don't like what the government's been up to, so why not get in the robot and fight? He's like, oh, okay. He's like, alright, I'm in. Fine, sure, great, let's do it. I'll be the Getter, dude. I'll be the one that's just got to be fat enough and stupid enough to not die. And Gimme and Dari are like, that lady, I recognize her from somewhere. And then Chikajima says, hey, keep all in on it, you two. Everything will be revealed in time. And that time's not far off, if his guess is to be correct. Fucking Chikajima.